Hello. In this quick video, we'd like to show how to sync a lens design project modeled in Rhino to Lumion in order to produce realistic images and animations. We must have lens design and Lumion installed. And in addition, in order to make the process easier, we need to download the Lumion Live Sync plugin to transfer the data. We can download the complement from photorealistic or get it directly from the Lumion website. We start to create a new project in Lumion and select the desired environment. Once we install the plugin, we are able to see the Live Sync toolbar and activate synchronization. During the working process, we recommend you to work using a faster visualization mode, for example, shaded or wireframe. Press the play button to start the transfer, and after a few seconds, all the geometry will be visible in the Lumion viewport. Since the original project has a negative terrain elevation, it is buried. So we'll hide the planting layer and work with the landscape tools, leveling the height. We can adjust the pressure and the size of the brush to have better control depending on the area we work until the imported terrain is visible. As you may see, the Lumion viewport maintains the same view as Rhino. We can disable the camera synchronization to get independent views. One advantage of having it enabled is that we can use a camera view that we have set up in Rhino. From the Materials tab, and with a good organization of the layers according to the materials, we could change any material by selecting a geometry, double-clicking on a material from the library to assign it, and finishing adjusting its properties and scale. From the weather panel, it's possible to adjust the intensity and direction of the sun or use realistic sky. Finally, we could move on to setting up our image for rendering. From the preview, we could continue making adjustments to the camera view, or adding effects such as realistic sky or image adjustments. There is the possibility to have different views to choose from, and also try and edit some custom styles. Once an image is selected, we choose if we want any additional channels, and we select the image size that we want in the final rendering. Hope it helps. Good luck.